is he? Where is that fool?
Cinderfella!
Lazy, useless fool, Cinderfella!
Good for nothing, ungrateful, never around when you need him, Cinderfella!
Cinderfella, you clumsy oaf! You've ruined my suit for the ball!
Cinderfella, my dancing slippers haven't been polished. How can I go to the ball if they haven't been polished?
Save your breath, sister. The miserable creature isn't here.
Not in the kitchen? But Cinderfella's always in the kitchen. He belongs in the kitchen. Ask his cat where he is.
Ask Attila. Don't be simple, Petra. Attila the cat is even more useless than Cinderfella. Besides, cats cannot talk.
Cinderfella talks to her.
Talks to a cat?
I've heard him.
That proves it. On top of everything else, the boy is quite mad. Talks to a cat? A cat? Can you imagine?
Cinderfella is quite mad. Yes, yes, Pedro. Anyone who would talk to a dumb cat has nothing between his ears. Ha, ha, ha.
Sister, do you see that? Attila hissed at us.
The brute, the beast.
I'll fix that miserable cat.
What are you going to do, brother?
Watch. No one, especially Cinderfella's mangy mouse catcher, hisses at me. Here a whack, there a whack, everywhere a whack, whack.
Here a whack, there a whack, everywhere a whack, whack.
She's talking!
Nonsense! She just has an unusual way of meowing. What's the broomy, Attila?
Give it another whack, brother. Stupid cat, useless cat, Cinderfella's cat.
You'll never hiss at me again, you nasty ball of fur.
Out the door with her, brother, out the door.
Into the alley with you, Cinderfella's cat.
Ow, ow, meow, meow. Meow, meow, meow.
Out.
Out.
Meow.
What is the meaning of this outrageous behavior?
It's all Cinderfella's fault, father. He has taught his cat to be very rude. She hissed at us.
I wasn't speaking to you, Petra.
Sorry.
I was speaking to your brother, Petra. Explain yourself, son.
What's to explain, father? I whacked the cat.
That's not what I meant. What is that thing in your hand?
This? It's a broomie.
A what?
A broom.
I wasn't speaking to you.
Sorry.
Broom? The thing that one of my charming children...
We are charming, so charming.
Would be seen with a broom in his hand, as if he was a common servant. What would the neighbors think? Shame, shame, shame. You, Pedro, and you, Petra, are young people of fashion and promise. You're delicate and refined, lovely to look at and charming to hear.
Yes, Daddy.
Don't call me Daddy.
No, Daddy.
You both are to read lovely books, think lovely thoughts, and wear lovely things. Perhaps tonight at the ball, you might attract the attention of attractive and especially wealthy noble. Someone might just pop the question.
What question?
Will you marry me?
Why would I want to marry my father?
Petra isn't as dumb as she looks. She's dumber! Ha ha ha!
He's making fun of me, Daddy. Make him stop. I'm sensitive.
Be quiet, Petra. And you, Pedro, drop that broom.
Mouse, mouse, it's a mouse.
She knows the cat is gone. Ah!
Where's Cinderfella? He'll know what to do.
Squeak, 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 squeak.
Ah! Help, help. Get away, get away.
Shoo, mouse, shoo.
Shoo, shoo, get away, mouse, help!
Where's Cinderfella?
Cinderfella!
Cinderfella, Cinderfella!
Where are you, Cinderfella?
Cinderfella, Cinderfella!
Here I am! Goodness, I wonder what has happened. I'll tell you what happened, you wretched child, a mouse!
A terrible mouse!
It was like a savage beast. We could have been devoured.
I am so sorry, stepfather, brother, sister. I'll speak to Attila about it.
See? What did I tell you? He speaks to cats.
Here we are preparing for the most important event of the social season, and you're outside playing in the alley. Selfish, selfish Cinderfella.
Nah, nah, selfish, selfish Cinderfella.
Silence! I wasn't out playing. I went to fetch water. A likely story. You've never shown proper gratitude, my boy. When your mother died, it was out of the kindness of my heart that I allowed you to stay on. I gave you a place to sleep.
Straw on the floor,
food,
whatever's left from a plate,
clothing, and what do I ask in return? Almost nothing. Only that you do hard work from morning to night.
Get up before daybreak, carry water, light fires, cook and wash.
Brush my hair, polish my nails, and make our clothes.
Now, I ask you, am I being unreasonable?
I'm grateful for the little I have.
Little? You call what there for you little? I'll have none of your impudence. Now, kids, you must hurry and get ready for the grand ball at the palace. I've been ready for hours. We must leave shortly.
Which reminds me, Cinderfella, you know I have big muscular arms. Or did you make it loose instead of making it fit?
Because when you tried it on, Petro, you could hardly move your hands.
Make him take that back, Daddy.
We can't sit in the kitchen arguing about nothing. We must make ready. And don't call me Daddy. Did you fix the gloves?
Yes, stepfather.
You won't forget to have hot chocolate ready for a return from the ball?
I won't forget.
Did you sprinkle perfume on the fans?
Yes, Petra.
I want the prettiest fan since I will be the most beautiful girl at the ball.
I see the print of a cat's paw on the floor. Disgusting. Kill it at once, Cinderfella.
Attila must have stepped in some mud.
Wretched cat. I cannot endure the charm of Cinderfella. He makes my own children seem detestable and drab. Therefore, his beauty and charms will be kept under the smudges of dirt and patches of rag. Always remember, Cinderfella, he who wants to eat bread must earn it.
Yes, stepfather. I am so handsome. Perhaps the princess will dance with me.
I am so beautiful. Perhaps every eligible guy will ask me to dance.
Who can that be? See who it is, Cinderfella.
Yes, stepfather.
Remember, no beggars.
I imagine they'll have all sorts of delicious things to eat at the palace.
Peppermint and salted cashews.
Sweet cakes and ice cream.
Yum, yum.
Stop it, both of you. A noble never has an appetite. Never. Tonight, you may each get one glass of gooseberry punch and nothing more.
Aww.
Good evening to one and all.
Who are you?
A waif, sir. And a hungry one at that.
A waif? A waif is nothing more but a homeless child. A ragamuffin. A cast-off. That means you're a beggar.
No beggars here. Out, out.
No charity here. Out, out.
Cinderfella!
I'm sorry, stepfather. I tried to stop her. She drifted right by me.
Well, in that case, she can drift right off. Be gone, beggar.
Ragamuffin.
Waif.
I haven't had anything to eat for days.
Feed one beggar, and before you know it, there's a line outside that door. Out, out.
Out, out.
Wait until you hear the news.
What news?
The grand ball. There's a grand ball at the palace tonight.
We know that. I'm dressed for it and so are you.
And we soon will be.
The majordomo is going up and down the streets announcing something important. It's so exciting, so thrilling, so unexpected. Don't you agree?
Hear ye, news from the palace, news from the palace.
We might agree if we knew what you were talking about.
Hear ye, news from the palace, news from the palace.
Ooh, Cinderfella, run outside and fetch the fellow in.
Yes, stepfather.
So unexpected, so marvelous.
You'd better sit down, Mrs. Hoppy. Your nerves are rattling.
Is it any wonder? Yes, I'll sit down.
Looks to me as if she's ready to fall down. Hush, Pedro. Remember, Manners makes a gentleman. This way, sir. Whatever can he be proclaiming?
That's him! That's the majordomo from the palace! Tell them the news!
The ball hasn't been cancelled!
Not that!
Certainly not! The grand ball will go on as planned.
Then what's all the fuss about?
As you know, the queen is a widow.
Uh-huh.
One child, the princess.
The princess? Oh yes, the princess. Go on.
Her Majesty has decided...
Decided what?
Hurry, hurry, hurry. News from the palace. Her Majesty, the queen, has decided it is now time for her daughter, the princess, to marry.
Marry?
Did you hear that, brother? The princess is going to marry.
Who's she going to marry, Majordomo?
That's yet to be decided. All males attending the grand ball are eligible. Tonight, a future prince for the kingdom will be selected.
Did you hear that? Did you hear?
I could be a prince! Prince! Cease! Since my children each received an invitation to the grand ball, it's obvious the queen has noticed my children. I consider this a great opportunity for you both. Make the most of it.
You'll have to excuse me. I have other houses to visit. It's been a long day.
Well, don't let us detain you.
Hurry, hurry, hurry. News from the palace. Her Majesty the Queen has decided it is now time for her daughter, the princess, to marry. All males attending the grand ball are eligible. Tonight, a future prince.
I must be off. I want to be the first one to arrive.
Children, there's not a moment to lose. Into your outfits. More powder and more paint for you. What is that awful stench? My God, perfume and mouthwash for you. I just know that one of you is going to make your father very proud.
I'm going to marry the princess.
Yes, you are.
I wish I could go to the ball. I don't see what's so funny.
You go to the grand ball at the palace.
You're dusty and dirty, as always.
You have nothing to wear.
True. You can't dance. You'd be laughed at. Imagine a creature such as you at the palace. Enough of that, children. We must get to the palace before Mistress Hati, who knows how many others will try to beat us to the princess. Don't forget, head high, shoulders back.
Head high, shoulders back.
Son, repeat after me. I'm handsome, I'm witty, I'm charming, I'm Princess Babe.
I'm handsome, I'm witty, I'm charming, I'm Princess Babe.
Lovely. Daughter, repeat after me. I'm beautiful, I'm witty, I'm enchanting, I'm noble Babe.
I'm beautiful, I'm witty, I'm enchanting, I'm noble Babe.
Splendid! And you, Cinderfella?
Yes, stepfather?
Get rid of this water bucket. I don't think it will hurt anyone or anything if I went to the grand ball. Do you? It would be so nice to have a nice suit and dance with the princess.
Dear small accomplishment, you seldom do.
I thought you left.
I was over there. In excitement, everyone forgot about me.
My stepfather will be angry, but I don't think people should go hungry.
You're going to give me something to eat?
I'll fix you a basket.
You're kind.
But you must leave right away.
Why do they call you Cinderfella?
My real name is Fella, but on cold winter nights, I like to sleep close to the dying embers in the fireplace. And when I do, I get cinders all over myself.
Can't be much fun living here. They don't treat you well.
Things were different when my mother was alive.
Don't you have anyone to care for you?
I have myself. Oh, and Attila. She loves me.
Attila?
My cat. Cinderfella!
Cinderfella! Cinderfella!
Wretched child! Coming, Petra. Petra, stepfather. This will hold you for a day or two. Hurry off. You must be seen, otherwise I'll be punished.
Good as gone. I feel sorry for that boy. I wish there was something I could do. Maybe there is. You must be a two. This could be a most unusual night, Attila. Anything could happen.
Yeah?
You'll find out.
Gloves! Gloves! If it isn't one thing, it's another. Oh, here they are! Oh dear! One of the pearls is loose.
Yeah.
It's you, Attila. Where have you been? Did you hear the wonderful news? Tonight, at the Granville, the princess is going to select a future groom. How I'd like to be there. I've never been to anywhere. I never do anything but cook and scrub, brush shoes and fasten buckles. It would be fun to pretend I'm at the palace. It would be fun to pretend I was dancing with the princess. Oh, I know. I'll pretend you're the princess.
Yeah?
We'll both pretend this kitchen is a palace ballroom. Your Highness, I should be most happy to accept your invitation to dance. Cinderfella!
Where are you, Cinderfella?
Never run when he's wanted, Cinderfella!
Cinderfella!
It was such a nice daydream, such a lovely, fancy dream. Poor Attila. She tried so hard to be ferocious. The truth is, she wouldn't harm a fly.
You'll find Cinderfella quite worthy.
What are you doing back here? I told you, you shouldn't have been seen. What if my stepfather sees you? It'll go hard with me.
Hush, hush. There's nothing to worry about. I've got someone to see you.
Who?
Your fairy godmother.
My fairy godmother? I didn't know I had one.
Everyone has a fairy godmother. But not every fairy godmother chooses to appear and lend a helping hand.
Are you really my fairy godmother?
Of course I am. My apprentice says you need help.
Apprentice?
Someone has to train future fairy godmothers. I'll go from place to place to see what's going on in the world. It's good experience.
You're not a beggar?
An apprentice fairy godmother must be adept at disguises. Otherwise, should be of no use. Let me have a good look at you. Turn round and round. Do as I say, child.
Maybe I'm still daydreaming.
Round and round, I say. Dear me, no. That clothes will never do. It's nothing but patches and threads.
What are you talking about?
Your clothes for the grand ball at the palace. You can't go dressed in that. Won't do at all.
I'm not going to the grand ball.
Of course you are, my child.
I can't dance. I'm only a servant. Besides, I don't want to go.
How you carry on, Cinderfella? Weren't you dancing with the cat and dancing nicely too?
How did you know?
A fairy godmother knows everything. There's nothing wrong being a servant, Cinderfella. But you are less than a servant. Much less. You're treated shabbily, and it's most unfair. You have a good heart, and you are kind. When you say you don't want to go to the grand ball, you're not being honest. You only say that so you won't be disappointed.
That's true. There's nothing I would rather do than attend the grand ball.
And so you shall.
I don't see how.
Trust me. You know the big chest in the attic?
Yes, it belongs to my father. It's empty.
Up to the attic with you. I think you'll find something pleasing in the empty trunk. Empty trunks are always interesting. Off you go.
But how?
I simply flick my magic wand 3 times. Turn about once, hop on 1 foot, and the magic is done. I'm not good at casting magic yet.
But
but...
Hurry, child. You're wasting time.
What shall I do?
You were right. Cinderfella is quite worthy.
How is Cinderfella going to get to the grand ball? What's that? He can't walk. Wouldn't look right. I hadn't thought of that. He'll need a coach. Fetch me the pumpkin. It'll do nicely. One pumpkin head coming up. He'll need a horse and a coachman. What do we have here, I wonder?
Squeak, squeak. Squeak, squeak.
What's this?
Squeak, squeak.
Meow, meow, meow. That's enough of that. Let me get a good look at you. Stand over here. Stand tall. Not bad. Not bad at all. You be the horse and you'll pull the coach.
I'm a cat.
For a few hours, you'll be a horse. A beautiful horse. Trim and sleek and high-stepping. It only takes a little bit of magic.
Squeak, squeak.
You be the coachman.
I'm a mouse, not a man.
I've known more than one man that I've considered a mouse. So don't carry on about it. You want to help Cinderfella, don't you?
Yes!
He's good to me, always dropping bits of cheese on the floor and never sitting on the track.
There we have it. All we need now is a coach.
One coach coming up.
What's up, fairy godmother? The old pumpkin into the coach routine. It's an oldie, but a goodie.
It's for Cinderfella. He's going to the grand ball.
Delighted. He is a charming boy. I see him sometimes when he comes to fetch water from the well.
Over there, pumpkin head, with the others.
How do we look?
Like nothing much at the moment, but give me time.
Only one coachman? Only one horse?
That's the whole point. Everyone will drive up to the palace with large coaches and many horses and far too many footmen. Each try to outdo the other. Cinderfella will be simplicity itself. A gorgeous, small coach, trimmed in real gold and silver, one beautifully attired footman, and one champion horse that will rival anything in the royal stables. The effect will be stunning.
Stunning!
Bravo, fairy godmother. Bravo.
That's enough. You have me blushing.
Cinderfella! Cinderfella! Cinderfella!
Where are you, Cinderfella?
Quick! Hide! Leave them to me.
Cinderfella! Where are you? Here I am, stepfather, in the kitchen, where I usually am. The gloves! The gloves! The gloves for my daughter! On the sewing table with the fans! Tonight will be stellar. Remember, Pedro, enchant the princess. Bewitch her with your charms. Enough with the giggles. Are not my children beyond compare? Did you ever see such loveliness? They are perfection. Perfection.
Double perfection with jelly beans on top.
You look, unusual, Pedro. Once the princess gets a look at me, I'm as good as well.
Yes, you are as good as well.
You look, unusual too, Petra. But, what's that star on the tip of your nose?
It's a beauty mark.
I thought you were supposed to wear a beauty mark on your chin or on your cheek, not on the tip of your nose.
Shows how much you know about fashion, drab little Cinderfella.
Sad little Cinderfella. Little Mr. Nobody, ignore the wrench. He hates you both because you are perfection.
Perfection?
I am perfection. Still wishing you could go to the grand ball, Cinderfella? How would people chuckle if they saw you walked in? Don't waste time while we're gone. Scrub the front steps, dust all the furniture, and turn down the beds. And don't forget to have hot chocolate ready. Boy, girl, wait for father. Boy, girl, wait for father.
Are they gone? They're gone. What dragon? Never mind about them. Mouse, Attila, apprentice.
Reporting for duty, fairy godmother.
Squeak, squeak, open it now, Cinderfella.
Cinderfella, Cinderfella, where are you, Cinderfella?
We're waiting, child.
Can it be? Is this the same boy? Is this Cinderfella?
Do I look all right?
You look fantastic.
You are truly handsome, Cinderfella, because your heart is truly beautiful. True beauty is within.
How can such a charming suit be in an empty trunk?
No, but we...
And my dancing shoes. They're made of gold.
This is Pumpkinhead, Cinderfella.
Pumpkinhead?
Pumpkinhead will be your coach.
Attila will be your carriage horse.
Mouse, your footman.
Squeak, squeak.
By the time the four of you reach the bed in a row, the magic will have taken hold.
I can hardly believe it.
Believe it!
One thing, Cinderfella, and this is the most important.
Yes?
The magic will not last forever. You must be home by midnight.
Midnight?
Otherwise, the coach will turn back into a pumpkin,
the horse back into a cat.
The footman returns to being a mouse.
Squeak, squeak.
Your suit will change into rats, and you wonder where the magic went.
I understand. I must be back in the kitchen by midnight.
Until that time, the night is yours. Run along, my dear. Enjoy being young. Enjoy the grand ball at the palace.
I will, fairy godmother, I will. Thank you.
What are you waiting for? Don't stand about wasting time. To the band in the road.
To the band in the road.
Let the magic of this night begin.
Thank you again, fairy godmother. Thank you.
Goodbye, Cinderfella. Goodbye.